super eruption is definitely catastrophic, but the likelihood of Yellowstone erupting in a super eruption any time within your lifetime is pretty small. So, you know, there's bigger things to worry about for sure. There's, you know, and there's other kinds of eruptions that have happened in Yellowstone. So we have to sort of take note of those and you know, what's the likelihood of a smaller eruption, or what's the likelihood of a steam eruption in Yellowstone is probably a more significant issue than is the, you know, the next super eruption. The reason that we sort of know that, you typically, when you're trying to predict volcanic eruptions, people have records that go back in time. You know, the sort of the past is the key to the future kind of approach. And so if you have a whole lot of eruptive events and you can actually start to understand some magmatic cyclicity, then you can put a probability on that eruption. With Yellowstone, there's only been three major eruptions, and they're the sort of the average time span between those eruptions is 710,000 years. The last one was 640,000 years ago. So, in effect, it's still not even safe, or it's still not even correct to say that it's going to happen anytime soon. But even more importantly, with those kinds of with probability, you need to have lots of events. You could flip a coin a couple times, and you're going to get heads both times. But it's, you know, sort of having a greater eruption cycle allows us to predict it a lot more precisely and more definitively. And so, you know, the chances of it erupting your lifetime is less than 1 in a million. The chance of dying in a car wreck is much higher. The chance of winning the lottery can even be higher. So, you know, it's something that people shouldn't be worried about. There's a lot of effort these days from sort of what I'd almost call fear-mongering, for people to try and, through public media, make a big deal out of the likelihood of this eruption. But really, there is a large consortium of geologists from the USGS, from the University of Utah, the University of Wyoming's involved in it, the Wyoming Geological Survey's involved, and the Yellowstone Volcano Observatory. We do have our finger on the pulse of the volcano, and are putting a scientific perspective on it instead of a fear-inducing or fear-mongering effect. I mean, people take videos of buffaloes running out, you know, they say, quote, running out of the park, but they were actually running towards tower. They, you know, sort of hype up every little event. And so part of the mission of the YVO has even become trying to suppress that, the people building fear amongst the U.S. public.